everybody. Welcome back to the channel. What's good? So yeah, YouTube is not pleased. I'm not uploading regularly. They don't like that. I've lost subscribers. If you're watching this and you're still here, thank you for sticking around. If you're new to my channel, click the subscribe button. Stay around, kick it with your girl. I am going to get back on my upload. I actually genuinely miss YouTube. I miss putting out content and giving my commentary. I actually uploaded on my other channel. But anyway, let's talk about Gorilla Glue, the man. So we've all seen the news where Gorilla Girl, her name is Tessica. I guess we can stop calling her that, but she's forever going to be Gorilla Girl. I mean, whatever. It is what it is. She actually got out of her sticky predicament. The doctor did a wonderful job at getting her hair back together. He said it's inflammation in her hair. It needs to heal. But she did not lose a whole ton of hair, at least from what the video, and I'll have the video within here if you haven't seen it. She had enough hair where she's not going to be necessarily out here doing bald-headed whole shit throughout the summer permanently. A lot of people, including myself, did not feel sorry for what happened to her, seeing as she deliberately chose to do that. I'm like, you know, you said in an interview, your son took the car, you was doing your hair, and you said, you know what, I'm going to go use the Gorilla Glue, and I'll wash it out later. If you already had Gorilla Glue purchased in your home, then I can only believe that you know what it's for, that you bought it to fix something. And I have to think that you read the can, because the can also, that particular one, says you must use it in a ventilated area. Do not breathe in the harmful vapor fumes, you know. And then for her to say, well, I'm going to sue them because I misunderstood. It said it was multi-purpose. The can showed the multi-items you can use it on. You know, y'all, let's not. I know it was a mistake in the sense of you wouldn't deliberately harm yourself, but it's not a mistake when you know what the fuck the product do, y'all. Like, that's not a race thing. People are trying to make it a race thing. Oh, you guys need to feel sorry for her. She's a black woman. She was a black woman that did the dumbest shit ever. And if she was a white woman, a pink woman, a Hispanic woman, an Indian woman, an Arabic woman, we're going to roast the fuck out of your ass too. It's not a race thing. It's a stupidity thing, okay? So, you know, I really, you know, like everybody else, felt the way, like, stop it. And then what, the fact that she got 30 days plus in this condition is something that lets me know maybe the urgency wasn't that bad, because in the midst of it all, she stopped and filled out the Instagram application to get her blue check mark. She said she did her GoFundMe for $1,500 because she figured I'm going to need some wigs when it's all over. But last time I checked, I think her GoFundMe got up to like $19,000 or something. But at the end of the day, I didn't contribute a dollar. I don't fund stupidity. Not a dollar of it. At the end of the day, I am glad the young lady's hair was salvageable, you know. And hopefully her health is good. You know, I mean, I feel sorry that she did something dumb and was a cement head for 30 plus days. She breathed in these vapors. You know, like, where did she spray it at? In the garage outside? Because it clearly said, don't use an enclosed space. I mean, if we've all used that product, if you have, then you know you have to use that, like, in your garage, in your backyard. It'll spark a flame. And if she did it in her bathroom, like, to just envision her going, and then getting her little toothbrush and whooping her edges, like the fume cloud. Like, girl, goodbye. But anyway, the stupidity of the young man who now, according to the article, it said if his lip don't heal up properly, they're going to have to cut his lip off. Not cut his lips off, but like the tip of his lip will have to get removed. He has to keep it. Of course, we're wearing a mask anyway, but just period, he has to keep that covered. So it must be like an open wound there. This fool on YouTube, I mean on his Facebook, was like, she lying, whatever. You want to convince us that one for clout? He claimed it wasn't for clout. Matter of fact, I'm going to stop right here. Let y'all listen to his interview, and then we're going to come right back to it, okay? Hold on.
Here I have it. That shit ain't true. I'm going to show y'all something. I got some Gorilla Glue right here. Super Glue Real. Why so? I'm going to take it, put it on this cup, put it in my mouth. Then I'm going to be the liquor and get it off. It's easy. Gorilla Glue garbage. Tell you now.
I feel like we need to clear the air because you don't
want
something crazy happening.
Put it on here.
You know what? I think...
Now. All right. So my first question is, first explain what encouraged you to do the Gorilla Glue Challenge.
Well, it really wasn't a challenge. I actually started it. I really didn't think, did you see what the young lady tried with the Gorilla Glue with her hair?
Uh-huh.
And I was like, okay. And I thought she was just playing around because I didn't think it was that serious that Gorilla Glue would actually do all of that, you know? I actually tried it a couple of times before. It never really worked for me for anything, like doing it actually on things. And that's what kind of, I was like, okay, well, she's lying and, you know, all these challenges going on. So I said, I'm going to go ahead and try it, you know?
Right.
And it went backwards, you know?
I got you. So walk me through the steps of what you did. Tell me what you do in the video with the cup and the glue.
But basically what I was doing was I was trying to show people that it wasn't as serious as she was making it to be, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So basically what I did was I trimmed the cup with some Gorilla Glue and placed it in my mouth for a few minutes, and which I thought that I could lick it off, kind of, you know, to moisten it and pull it right off. But that didn't work, though.
So talk about the experience when you went to the hospital. How long were you there, and what treatment did you receive there?
Well, I was there for maybe about a little over an hour, 2 hours or so. Basically, I had my pressure was up. I mean, I was going through a lot of distress also. And they did like a peeling, basically a moistening peeling, you know, to get it off of that. For my upper skin on my lip, you know. So basically all that has been torn off, you know.
And what is the recovery process?
Basically keep it covered up. You don't want, you know, with all these things floating around and stuff like that, you don't want to get it infected. And you don't want anything like that to happen, you know. Keep it covered up with all these viruses going on and stuff like that. And you know, I have medication I rub on it to keep it, you know. And hopefully it just heals up. It doesn't get infected or anything like that.
Did they give you like a time frame for how long you have to keep it moisturized, keep it covered up?
Yeah, 2 to 3 weeks. And once it starts to dry, I'm going to take it off and let some air breathe, you know, let it catch air, you know.
Okay.
But right now, I really need to keep it covered, you know.
All right. So when we researched your name, we saw that you're on Dr. Oz in regards of the ice cream challenge. And then from looking on your Facebook page, we do see that you're a rapper. And many insinuate that you're doing these challenges to seek attention, to boost a rap career, or even just to go viral. So what are your thoughts on that?
Well, I would never want to stick no Gorilla Glue to my lip and have it stuck there and have to go through all the situations I went through. Basically, I was trying to start. Of course, everybody knows social media runs things right now. Everybody's on social media. It gets a lot of attention, and that's what's going on. I mean, there's a lot of different challenges. So I wouldn't say that I'm doing it to boost my career, because people start a new challenge every day, you know? They start the mom challenge, the brother challenge. So what, if that's the case, why are those people doing it, you know? I mean, actually, it's just a part of social media, but I didn't think it was going to go this far, you know? But if it helps, it helps. And if it doesn't, it doesn't. But that's not what I did it for. I don't want to be sitting up here like this. I mean, you got Valentine's Day coming up. I can't even kiss my old lady, you know? That's not what I'm trying to do.
So what is your message to people watching this right now who are seeing these challenges? What is your overall message to them?
Well, see, the thing is, I don't want to send out a bad message. The same thing with the ice cream situation, which was completely blown out of proportion, but I don't want nobody to try, especially these kids, you know? They look at stuff on the internet and they be like, okay, they're trying. Now, if somebody can't go and do this, and this could be worse. You know, somebody could die. Anything could happen. So this is definitely one not to try. Let's just stop this now. It's over with for that. Let's act like it never started, you know? It's very harmful, and it could harm a lot of people, you know?
Right. Well, that's all the questions I have. I wish you a speedy recovery, and thank you for your time.
All right. Thank you, too. Y'all take care.
You, too. Thank you.
You didn't do that for clout. You a up-and-coming rapper. What did he look? 60? I don't know. 55? Up-and-coming rapper. And according to the article, it said that you got in trouble for licking the ice cream. Now, he didn't get in like jail time. He was charged with mischief because he licked the ice cream, uploaded that to the internet, but then the ice cream he licked, he purchased it. Thankfully, he did that and didn't leave it on the shelf like everybody else. But he said in the article he wanted to be famous. So if you did that for fame, you trying to convince us you didn't glue your lips to this damn thing? You not going to tell me you didn't think your lips was going to stick. You're not going to convince me, because I'm doing the commentary. You're not going to convince me that you didn't think your lips would be stuck. He said, I'm a glue them and lick it off. What? It's the name Gorilla Glue frightens me. When I had to use it for something, I had on gloves. Those gloves from the Dollar Tree that the with the little beads on the bottom, but they're not beads. Gripper rippers. I don't know. I was terrified to use the shit for fear I would be stuck to something or my fingers or something fused together. And y'all just putting it in y'all fucking hair. And the mucous membrane, when you lick. I am 100% convinced that this was for the clout. With Tessica, I don't think she meant, I really think she thought, I believe her when she said she thought she could rinse that shit out. I thought she was gonna be like, see ladies, Gorilla Glue work. Girl, I use Gorilla Glue, but I washed it out and it didn't quite go that way. But at the end of the day, it does not matter, honey. My opinion don't matter, but I can state it because it's my platform. But oh boy, Gorilla Boy, huh? You deliberately put that shit on the cup. And the picture, y'all, if I can remember to put the picture over here. The picture of that cup stuck on his lips. I can't. Are you serious? He's serious. Then he said in that interview, I can't kiss my lady. I would have broke up with you. When I saw you gluing it on the lid, we would have broke up. We would have broke up. You won't ever kiss me again, because we would have broke up. I can't remember, look at this camera, because I'm sure looking at me versus looking at y'all. I am outdone at the need for this social media fame and doing anything. This is a product that could essentially kill, it could kill you. You could injure yourself to the point where you can't recover from it. So next we're going to have someone, I used it for lube because I wanted to make my vagina tighter. Are any of you loosey gooseys out there going to try to get your grippers back gripping? I mean, disclaimer, because I'm sure, Lord, disclaimer. Do not use this on your penis. Do not use this on your vagina. Do not use Gorilla Glue on any part of your body. I am making jokes, but God forbid someone watching me says, yes, yes, lube. Please do not use Gorilla Glue as lube or to get that snapper back to snapping. Finish up my wine. I saw that. I said, really? Gorilla guy? A red solo. It's always the red solo cup. What is it? That red solo cup didn't cause many a problem. Okay, whatever's in it, That's your ass. If something's gonna go down, it's a lot of memories. I don't have any. But I have memories of others watching people, and they had that red cup, and it was just a lot of, I ain't gonna put the business out here, but I see you. I see you. And then grandma saw you, and auntie, and the police, and 2 to 5, but whatever. I've said too much. Anyway, that's it on this commentary. I mean, I don't have time for the stupidity. I'm not gonna, you know, nobody gonna make me feel away because I don't feel sorry for what happened to her and all that. Oh my God, she's a black woman, like I said. Or if I didn't say it, I'll say it. If she was white, Chinese, Hispanic, pink, green, her ass would still have been roasted. She chose to use that product as a substitute. She didn't mix it up. She said, oh yeah, I got Gorilla Glue in here. And then, I'm gonna leave you with her lawsuit. She said, I'm gonna sue because they said it was multi-purpose, and that confused me. My wig, y'all, come on now. If you look at the can, and if I remember, I'm gonna put it up here somewhere. The multi-purpose things it listed, it was nothing human. It was nothing human. Nothing human. Furniture, plastic, metals, wood, or whatever. And it definitely said keep away from skin, from your eyeballs, and stuff like that. Just the thought of her. Can I tell y'all, if I had, first of all, why is it, I don't even see how you can have an accident and put it in your hair. I can see an accident on your hands because you're using it. But here, how? Now I feel like it could be good mace, though. I may get a can, so when I do some of my Uber Eats, I may just get a can and get your ass. Because that's what would have happened to me. The first, girl, I would have, I would have flew to the ER. You hear me? She had in her hair 30 days. And this fool, he gonna lose a lip if it don't heal. The article said that if his lip do not heal, because they peeled that shit off, like he didn't have no surgeon fly his ass out to Hollywood. They like, rip. If that hole in his mouth, or whatever it is, open wound, they said if it don't heal in 3 weeks, they gotta cut it off his lip, like the tip of it. Can you imagine? You viral now. You're viral now. You're a lipless, up-and-coming rapper. That's not a good combo. You need your lips to rap. Anyway, that's it for this video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Thank you for coming and stopping. Hopefully, you'll check out some of my other videos. If you are, you've been around kicking it with your girl from day one, I see you, I miss you, and I thank you for still kicking it with your girl. Click the subscribe button. It'll be somewhere over there, and I'll be back with another video. Bye, y'all. And please, y'all, stop with the Gorilla Glue.